There's a basic rule in politics: when you're near a microphone, you're never alone. Gordon Brown forgot that rule today. It was the day when Gordon met Gillian.
I'm absolutely ashamed of saying I'm Lib.
And the encounter got worse when 66-year-old Gillian Duffy broached the touchy subject of immigration in a place where many feel foreign workers are stealing their jobs.
But all these Eastern Europeans what are coming in, where are they flocking from?
Gordon Brown made nice.
It's been very good to meet you.
But that's not what he really thought. What he really thought was captured afterwards by the radio microphone he was still wearing.
That was a disaster. She's just this all-bigoted woman. I think it's ridiculous.
Ridiculous is what Gillian Duffy thought her prime minister's comments were when they were played back to her.
You're joking. Where was I a bigot?
Someone has just handed me the tape. Let's play it and see if we can hear it.
By the time he got to a radio interview where his comments were again replayed, it was clear Gordon Brown was having a bad day. So bad that Brown went back to Gillian Duffy's house to apologize in person.
If you like, I'm a penitent sinner.
Penance may not be enough for a politician already trailing in the opinion polls and one with a reputation for having a fierce temper. In a society that still values politeness, though, it's a good bet that insulting little old ladies is not a vote getter.
Tonight at 6, the two faces of Gordon Brown.
A major embarrassment on the campaign trail.
A crash and burn moment.
This election was supposed to be decided in a series of televised debates between the three main party leaders. But it is an unguarded, off-camera moment that may decide it.
She's just this all-bigoted woman.
Mark Phillips, CBS News, London.